Shift our focus from Netherlands to the country of Denmark. We have with us Mr. Søren Tranberg Hansen, Consul Deputy Head of Mission Science and Innovation, Consulate General of Denmark in Bengaluru. We welcome Mr. Hansen. Over to you.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for inviting me here for this exciting conference. As you said, I'm working for the Danish Consulate here in Bengaluru, and I'm the Science and Innovation Consul. And Deputy Head of Mission. I joined half a year ago. Before that, I was a researcher and did research in robotics and AI, stuff like that. So I'm fairly new to diplomacy. And when I started the position half a year ago, I had some introductory I was a part of an introductory program at the Ministry of Science and Higher Education. And we talked a bit about the difference between the educational systems in India and Denmark. And Denmark is, as you probably know, it's a very small country. We are only about less than six million people. And we have no natural resources. So education is actually the only resource we have. On the other hand, we have India, which is abundant on a lot of competences and people and resources. So I was told there was about 40,000 universities and colleges in India, which is a staggering number. We have maybe less than 200 in Denmark. So that's just that was a bit an eye-opener for me that the amount of skilled people that is in India is really impressive. I work for what is called the Danish Innovation Center here in Bangalore, and Denmark has located seven innovation centers around the world, and that has been they have been very strategically selected. So that's in US and Germany and in Israel and China and all the countries where there are a good educational system and a good innovation system that Denmark can collaborate with. So the idea of having these innovation centers is to elevate the Danish system because we are small, so we need to collaborate with other countries. And India has been selected as a strategic priority. And we do that by working with universities and companies and also government agencies in this triple helix model. For this year, we will have a special focus on deep tech and also space, green value chains and energy. And these topics are not completely randomly selected. They are part of what is called the Green Strategic Partnership that has been signed by the prime ministers of our respective countries, Modi on the Indian side and Mette Frederiksen on the Danish side 2 years ago. Along with the Green Strategic Partnership, which is a political framework, there's a joint action plan that kind of specifies on which areas we need to work on. And that's not only in education, that's also in the water sector and energy. It's quite broad, but there is formulated quite a few objectives within science and education and skilling where we need to collaborate, and that is among others best practice sharing, best practice in teacher upskilling and vocational education. It's also promoting lifelong learning and an obligation to initiate different pilot projects when it comes to vocational training. so there is a political wish on both sides that Denmark and India works together on education. Just yesterday, actually, I had a call from a business college in Denmark who told me that they are launching a program where they are upskilling chefs actually from the TAS chain, the very hotel that we are at right now. So within the next few years, 300 chefs from the TAS chain will come to Denmark and learn about Scandinavian cuisine. That is something that has happened completely on their own. It's like institutional collaboration. We have not from the government or anything. We are not part of that. It's something that has happened because two institutions have met and agreed upon that there would be some opportunity here. But the matter of the fact is that we have a problem coming up, and we have actually known that for a long time in Denmark. The double demographic challenge. So the population is the age of the population is increasing. We have more and more elderly people, and we have fewer and fewer young people to take care of them. So Denmark is as a population is getting older. It's a you see the same pattern all over Europe and also China. But it is a matter of the fact that we are actually lacking workforce in Denmark, and we can expect that that would be even more so in the years to come. And the workforce we are lacking is not necessarily people with a high academic degrees. It's actually it's people with to a large extent it's people with vocational training, electricians, plumbers, welders, and so on, and maybe. Something in between, but there is there will be a lack of workforce in Denmark for and there already is in these areas. So one of the initiatives that we are looking into, maybe working with in the coming years, is a program called Mentor to Impact, where people with vocational training from India can come to Denmark in a long term. It would be like a long term internship. Maybe a year and a half, and work with Danish companies and institutions. So, to one at one one side is that they will we will provide the upskilling, but the other side of it that we will have additional workforce that we are lacking. So that's one area of collaboration we are looking into in the future. Another initiative we are looking into is the way we teach. Is somewhat different. I was when I took my university degree, it was very much focused on problem-based learning, where you you don't fix the curriculum. You have you identify a problem that you work on as a student, and then by trying to solve this problem, you get you gain your knowledge. And that's a very common approach in the Scandinavian countries. As far as I understand, a little less common in India, but there are, last year there was a big conference about this particular way of teaching, sponsored by UNESCO, and later this year a new conference on that will come up. It was quite popular, more than 600 participants from different educational institutes in southern India were part of it. So that might be an area also where we can collaborate. Besides that, we have from our side at the Innovation Center, we are launching a few initiatives where we sponsor students from India to come to Denmark on shorter exchange visits. So. Right now, I'm working on an elite summer school in robotics. Denmark has a very strong robotics sector, and they are also in the, but they are also lacking engineering competences. So we will initiate a program where some of the best robotic students in India can come to Denmark for summer school, and we are doing a similar program, which is. On sustainability, actually two programs that we will launch here in the spring. So these are kind of very small steps, at least, but still, these are some of the initiatives we from the Innovation Center are working on right now. Overall, I would say the political momentum for collaborating has never been better. There's a huge interest on both sides for working together on education. And I think there's that can be in vocational training, it can be in exchanging teaching methods and also the exchange of students. So the future look bright, I think, in this area in particular for collaboration. That's where we both have interest in working together, and we both have something to put on the table. So. With that, I will conclude my talk, and I wish you have a very good and interesting day for the remaining sessions here. Thank you so much.
I hope some young students from the cooking academy in Sweden, from Denmark, can also come to India. Yes. And become chef. Exchange of cuisine. But thanks a lot. Søren Hansen, for sharing with us various aspects of areas where Denmark and Indian can collaborate in terms of education, vocational training. You have mentioned vocational training, where you're looking for skilled people from India. Maybe that can be a lead for the Indian policymakers or the Indian institutes. Also talked about innovation center, robotics, and that is also important. And as you rightly said, the future is bright indeed. Thank you so much.